Your introduction. In order to characterize a printer, a relationship between the printer's input and the resulting output color needs to be established. One approach consists in using a spectral prediction model. The benefit of using a spectral prediction model is that the printer can be characterized as a function of the printing process parameter, such as the surface coverage of the ink transmittance, the paper reflectance, the dot gain, and so on. Therefore, using such kind of model, we can, for instance, calculate the surface coverage of the inks to obtain a desired color. As you know, the existing classical models are the Clapper-Yule model, the Unison modified spectral Neugebauer model, ink spreading enhancement of both these two models, and here, in order to obtain high prediction accuracy, we can use, for instance, the cellular Unison model. What is new in our contribution is that we introduce ink spreading within the cellular Unison model by accounting for the ink spreading phenomenon of the inks within each cellular subdomain. The proposed method provides high prediction accuracy with a small number of calibration patch reflectance measurements in the case of three inks printing only 35. Some words about the content. First, I will introduce the physical phenomena that are due to the printing process, such as the optical dot gain, the ink spreading phenomenon of the inks. Then I will show the basics of both the Unison model and the cellular Unison model. After that, I will show how to introduce ink spreading within the cellular Unison model and how the ink spreading characterization can be performed with red, green, and blue sensor responses instead of using full spectral reflectances. And finally, I will conclude by showing prediction accuracy of these models. The reflected light of a color halftone is given by the light that goes through the ink is reflected to exit from that ink. In fact, the role of the ink is to absorb some part of the light, plus the light that is simply reflected by the paper. However, due to the diffusing properties of the paper and ink combination, some part of the light that goes through the ink can be multiple times reflected and refracted to exit from the paper, yielding more absorption of light. And this phenomenon is known as lateral propagation of light or optical dot gain. When an ink dot is printed on paper, we generally observe that the ink spreads, yielding more effective surface coverages, the surface coverages of the ink that are really printed, than nominal ink surface coverages, the nominal ink that we have asked the printer to print. When the same ink dot is superposed or printed on the top of another solid ink, we observe a different ink spreading. In fact, the ink spreading phenomenon is dependent on the ink superposition condition. It is different when one ink is printed on paper only, superposed with one solid ink, another solid ink, or two solid inks, for instance. The Unison modifies spectral Neugebauer model is widely used to predict the spectral reflectance of a color halftone as a weighting sum of the effective coverages of the colorant and their corresponding spectral reflectances. In addition, one exponent n is used to modelize the nonlinear relationship we have between the effective coverages and their corresponding spectral reflectances. By taking a careful look at this equation, we can see that in order to improve the spectral prediction accuracy of the Unison model, we can play only with two kinds of parameters. The first one is the Unison n factor, and it mainly depends on the optical dot gain, so the lateral propagation of light. The other parameters are the effective coverages of the colorant, and they mainly depend on the physical dot gain, so the ink spreading phenomenon of the inks. In the Unison model, we have as an input the effective ink coverages. And then we have to compute the effective coverages of the colorants in order to predict the spectral reflectance of a given color halftone. And this leads to the question how we can obtain the effective coverages of the colorant knowing the effective ink coverages. The figure illustrates one possible color halftone made of the three cyan, magenta, and yellow inks. In this case, we have eight possible colorants, like, for instance, the paper white, the yellow ink only, the cyan ink only, and maybe the superposition of the cyan and the yellow ink, which gives the green colorant. Assuming independently printed cyan, magenta, and yellow inks, these effective coverages can be computed with the Michell equation. For instance, the proportion of printed green colorant is given by the proportion of printed cyan and yellow ink when there is no magenta. And this is similar to trilinear interpolation of the coefficients. In order to obtain higher prediction accuracy than with the Unison model, in the cellular Unison model, we divide the CMY surface coverage unit cube into 8 subcubes formed by all possible combination of 0, 50, and 100% nominal coverages of the three inks. The left figure illustrates one of the possible 8 subdivisions, the one where the nominal ink coverages vary between 0 and 50%. At vertices of each subdomain, we measure the 8 spectral reflectances of the primaries. And I said primaries instead of colorant with the Unison model, because in this case, we measure the spectral reflectances of halftones and not solid tones. In the given example, we have applied only one cellular subdivision. And in this case, we have to measure 27 primaries reflectances. In order to increase the prediction accuracy of this model, we can, for instance, apply a second level subdivision. But in this case, we have to measure 125 primary reflectances. And this is too much. As an alternative to further cellular subdivision, we propose to introduce ink spreading within the cellular Unison model. In the cellular Unison model, the spectral prediction of a color halftone of given CMY nominal ink coverages is carried out by first finding the cellular subdomain where the nominal ink coverages vary. Then we normalize these nominal ink coverages between 0 and 1. And finally, the spectral prediction of that halftone is obtained by trilinear interpolation of subdomain primary reflectances. In fact, the effective coverages of the primaries are computed with the de Michell equation, and the spectral reflectances of the primaries have been measured at the vertices of the considered subdomain. And this is exactly the Unison equation. As I told you before, as an alternative to further cellular subdivision, we propose to account for the ink spreading phenomenon of the ink within each subdomain. We therefore generate three ink spreading functions, one for each ink, mapping the normalized nominal ink coverages to the normalized effective coverages. The figure illustrates the ink spreading phenomenon of the cyan ink within the cellular subdomain where the nominal ink coverages vary between 0 and 50%. A 25% nominal coverage of that ink, and therefore a 50% normalized nominal coverage of the same ink, we obtain 61% normalized effective coverages. And this is due to the strong ink spreading phenomenon we observed for this print. And this leads to the question how we can obtain these three ink spreading functions within each subdomain. The approach is to jointly fit the three ink spreading functions on an halftone patch located at the center of the considered subdomain. In the subdomain where the nominal ink coverages vary between 0 and 50%, we will take an halftone at 25% nominal coverages for the three ink. And then we fit the corresponding effective surface coverages, normalized effective surface coverages, by minimizing the sum of square differences between the spectral measurement of that color halftone and its corresponding spectral prediction. At the end, we obtain the exponent function by quadratic interpolation between the points 0, 0, 0.5 normalized nominal coverage and its corresponding fitted normalized effective coverage and 1, 1. Therefore, at model calibration, we generate 24 exponent functions, one for each ink in each subdomain, by fitting on only 8 halftones, so the 8 subdomain centers. In total, the model needs to be calibrated with 27 primaries plus 8 ink spreading measurements, so only 35 calibration measurements. And now we have everything to build the final model. At model calibration, first we generate the 24 ink spreading function, and then at runtime, for each color halftone of given CMY nominal ink coverages, first we normalize these nominal income ranges between 0 and 1. Then we compute the normalized effective coverages by making use of this encoding function. After that, we can compute the effective coverages of the primaries with the Demi-Shell equation. And finally, we can compute the spectral prediction of that color halftone with the unison equation. In order to obtain an optimal unison n factor, we can, for instance, iterate across all possible n factor between 1 and 14 by step of 0.2. And then for each of these n factor, first we establish all the encoding function, and then we run a spectral prediction over all the test sample or only the calibration samples only. And we take as the optimal n factor the one that minimizes the mean spectral prediction error. In order to avoid spectral reflectances measurement as much as possible, we propose to establish the encoding curve with red, green, and blue sensor responses instead of using spectral reflectances. In order to demonstrate the feasibility of using sensor responses instead of spectral reflectances, we simulate RGB sensor devices by the DIN standard RGB sensitivities for densitometric measurement under a D65 illuminant. The response of the sensor M is given by the following equation. In this situation, the new fitting procedure becomes a sum of square minimization between the converted to sensor responses measure spectral reflectance and its converted to sensor responses spectral prediction. And we observe that the normalized effective coverage is fitted with sensor responses are similar to those obtained when fitting with spectral reflectances. In the subdomain where the nominal incoverages vary between 0 and 50%, as you can see in that table, the fitted effective surface coverages are almost the same. We also observe that these coefficients do not deviate more than 1.5% in every subdomain, and therefore we expect to obtain the same prediction accuracy either when characterizing ink spreading with spectral reflectances or only with sensor responses. And knowing that the cost of including RGB sensor devices within a printer is much lower than including a spectrophotometer, the proposed method offers the potential of characterizing printer at runtime at moderate cost. In order to test the prediction accuracy of these models, we've printed 125 uniformly distributed test samples with classical rotated screen for two kinds of different printer. The first one is an electrophotographic laser printer, and the second one an inkjet Canon Pro printer. The accuracy metric is defined as a delta E94 difference between predicted and measured test sample under a D65 illuminant. In order to compare our new model with the prior art, we first considered the ink spreading enhanced unison model. It's a standard unison model that has been enhanced to account for ink spreading phenomenon of the ink in all superposition condition. We also considered the standard cellular unison model and our new ink spreading enhancement of that model when either characterizing ink spreading with full spectral reflectances or with sensor responses. The first figure illustrates the spectral prediction accuracy of these three models for the electrophotographic print. By comparing the cellular unison model with our new ink spreading enhancement of that model, we can see that the mean delta E94 prediction error is divided by more than 2. And this is, in fact, quite good because we added only 8 more calibration measurements. By comparing the cellular unison model with our new the ink spreading enhanced unison model, we can see that the IS-YNSN model offers slightly better prediction accuracy, even if it uses less calibration measurements. And this is due to the fact that the strong dot gain we observe for this electrophotographic print is well captured by the IS-YNSN model that has been enhanced for accounting the expanding phenomenon of the ink in all superposition condition. The second figure illustrates the prediction accuracy for the Canon print. And in this case, we observe similar results. By comparing the cellular unison model with our new expanding enhancement of that model, we can see that the prediction accuracy is divided by more than 2, and the YNSN model offers slightly better prediction accuracy than the CYNSN model, even if it uses less calibration measurement. We have also conducted a similar test on offset print, proofing device like a CUDA-CA Proval, other inkjet prints for different inks, different half-toning algorithm, and we observed that the CYNSN model provides mean delta 94 prediction error around 0.4, and this is quite good because we use only a few calibration measurements. The last figure illustrates comparison between the ink spreading enhanced model when either characterizing ink spreading with sensor responses or with spectral reflectances. And as you can see, we obtain exactly the same prediction accuracy for the electrophotographic print. In conclusion, we have shown how to introduce ink spreading within the cellular Yulnison model by accounting for ink spreading of the ink within each subdomain. The proposed method offers high prediction accuracy with a small number of spectral measurements, and we have also shown how to characterize ink spreading with red, green, and blue sensor responses instead of using full spectral reflectances, and the second proposed method offers the potential of characterizing printers at runtime at moderate cost. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Romain. We have time for one, two questions. Yes.
Thank you very much for a nice presentation. Maybe my question is out of focus on your research, but I have a question about N factor. And in your presentation, the N factor is not dependent on the ink and the wavelengths, that you can extend that into the wave dependency. Do you have any comment on that?
In fact, you're right. There is a strong correlation between...
Could you say that again?
In fact, you're right. There is a strong correlation between the Yulnison N factor and the effective coverages, so the physical dot gain. If you, for instance, take a low N factor value, then the ink spreading curves we generate will compensate this low N factor value by a strong physical dot gain. It's hard to distinguish. There is a big correlation. So what I did is I fitted the optimal N factor. In this case, either for the electrophotographic print or for the inkjet print, this value has been set to 14. And then I have generated the corresponding ink spreading function that takes mostly account of the physical dot gain.
Physical dot gain.
What?
What's your final word? Physical dot gain?
Physical dot gain.
Physical dot gain. Mechanical dot gain.
Mechanical dot gain.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, good. How about, maybe in the case of optical dot gain, you have a wavelength dependency. That's my poor understanding of English. You know, optical dot gain, the mechanical dot gain is there. The optical dot gain will be dependent on the wavelengths. The N factor will be dependent on the wavelengths in the physically.
If you look at my previous publication at the CGIF conference, I've created a new enhancement of the Yulnison model by taking into account that the optical dot gain is different for the inks.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, but this in this case, because we go with we create small Yulnison models, mm-hmm. we are in small parts of the unit cube coverage. And in this case, we have less this effect of the different mechanical dot gain of the inks.
Thank you. I got it.
Okay, so I think you have more questions. You can ask Romain during the coffee break. We're going to close the multi-ink printing session. I would like to thank all the speakers again.